what's up, everybody? Welcome to ZOMG, our video game trailer reaction show. I am here with my co-hosts.
If you want anyway.
And it's Malika Lim.
And we're going to be watching Crackdown 3, the E3 2017 official trailer. Just came out last week. I think we all got a chance to see it at E3.
Oh, yeah.
I played it. You played it.
Yep.
You watched.
I watched you play it while sipping a alcoholic beverage.
You were also filming me playing it. And you were doing a lot more than that. Yeah, you were sipping alcohol and running the camera?
Well,
that's impressive.
Can't wait to see that footage.
You're with me for a reason.
Yeah, okay. What do you think, man? You excited?
Oh, yeah. I'm super stoked. I was real big in the Crackdown. That's the reason all my friends got 360s, so we could play it together, jumping from rooftop to rooftop just to try and get every agility orb. It's solid.
Solid. All right. So I think we should just watch this trailer, yeah. And we'll talk about it afterwards. Let's do this. All right. Here we go.
In 4K.
Oh, it's not in 4K. No, it wouldn't matter. I mean, look how small it is on the screen. Sumo Digital.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's an interesting way to spell
they
Jackson.
Killed the power around the world. We're going to light it back up because this is far from over. In fact, it's only just begun. That's why we brought in you. You got the talent.
Now I'm telling you put him in anything, I will buy it.
Today, you throw grenades. Boom. Tomorrow, you'll be throwing cars. Forget dropping bombs. You're dropping buildings. Now it's time to get to work.
Oh, God, it's so good.
Time to step up your boom. Oh, that's my cue. It's go time. Yeah, son.
If he's not a downloadable character in the game, I'm going to be really upset.
Well, he's got to be in the game, right?
Welcome to the agency.
Yeah.
Determination to conquer all my ambitions. Made it to this position, and so my disposition. Not seeing the limits.
Killing the
competition. Yeah, I'm a beast. Now I'm a beast. Ready to feast. Calm and peace. Not least. I think that I'm number one. Just to keep it 100. 0 to 100. So you have a component. Are you a beast? Are you a beast? You ready to feast? Or are you a beast? Not the least. Do you think you're number one? Can you keep it 100? 0 to 100. Show me how much you want it.
Some people never have trouble. That's why they don't know what the struggle is. I don't pay the cost.
Oh, yeah.
That was the whole kind of thing of it. It's like this comic book style world.
Oh, yeah.
Cell shading. Yeah.
Nice. Nice.
Oh, yeah.
That's
clean. That's clean.
I really like that it looks like Crackdown.
Yeah.
That's like a new installment, new system. Looks like Crackdown.
Yeah,
because I don't really want it to not be Crackdown.
Exactly. That's one thing I was gonna say. It was just in all the beautiful trailers we saw, and so I like that they stuck with the style of it, and I think it plays really well. When I played it, just the movement was just so on point, just jumping from building to building. It felt just like it was. It was like I got to play it. I was at the Xbox Team Coco, like little Microsoft mixers, and so they had like the setup for Crackdown. They had a few of the devs there, and so they were able to like be like, check that out and watch me do it, and they were really impressed. And I told them, I was like, no, I played this game a shit ton, and they said I was their favorite person to watch because I just was
getting into it.
But like, you know, the weapons, they had like a rocket launcher.
Yeah,
they had that, and then they had a
dude. I just like punching people.
Oh yeah, the punching people was good. But then I found a gun that shoots black holes, and that was a game changer.
Right on. Yeah, I like that. You know, I feel like a lot of people compare this game to Saints Row and that they have similar stuff. And yeah. I honestly like these way better than Saints Row. I feel like Saints Row doesn't take itself seriously enough. And I like that Crackdown builds a world and really exists within that world. And I think the mechanics are better. Mm-hmm. I think it feels better to play it. And, you know, there's similar stuff going on there, but the mechanics are really tight. I like the way it feels. It makes me feel like a fucking superhero. I was telling these guys, I don't know if I've ever played a game that makes me feel as much like a superhero. And it's not a superhero franchise game. It's just, it's its own property. But you feel, by the end of it, the way you upgrade your character and the fact that you get to choose how that character is upgraded.
Yeah.
If you use your strength powers more, that's what you end up becoming.
Yeah.
You know?
How do you guys feel about this, like, Xbox One X? And this is one of the games that's coming with it.
Now, so you saw me play it. You played as well. I'm guessing they had the Xbox One X set up there. Mm-hmm. This is what actually kind of converted me over to believing in the Xbox One X, because when we see these YouTube videos, when we see the presentation at E3 and we're watching a live stream of it, I think one of the problems that we're going to have with all these new games made for HDR and 4K is we can't see how they're optimized in these live streams. You can't. Like, you're not getting the full experience. When we sat down at a station to play it, holy crap, it is beautiful. The colors.
Yeah.
Holy shit. And I was telling her, like, I saw no anti-aliasing at all. Everything was silky smooth. It was like butter. The frame rate was just so smooth. And that stuff's hard to get across in these 30 frames per second videos that are up on YouTube and shit. Like, you just can't tell. You can't tell how in person that looked absolutely gorgeous.
I know. I think the only thing that the minor, and this is the most nitpicky thing, is I feel like a year ago we were being told that, like, games that came out for Xbox exclusives were coming to PC too, and now we got the Xbox One X and we're getting all these Xbox One X exclusives, nothing coming to the PC.
This is on PC
too.
Well,
there's the Xbox Everywhere.
Yeah. When? It's Xbox Everywhere.
Everywhere.
It's Windows 10 and Xbox. They're not announcing. Oh. They're calling them. This is the whole joke.
Yeah. Okay.
Is they're calling everything Xbox exclusives, but they're actually coming out on PC as well.
Oh, man, your boy.
Because they're calling Xbox exclusives also Windows 10 Xbox.
You remember that internet video that was going around of that guy in this European club, and then he finds out that Osama bin Laden's been killed and is like, and it just changes his whole demeanor. Like, that's how I feel right now. Like, I didn't know that that was happening.
That was a whole joke with everything during the Microsoft conference. They're like, Xbox exclusive, also on Windows,
right?
Because it's the Xbox Everywhere program where that's how I play Gears 4. I bought Gears 4 on the Xbox One, and I can log into my PC, go to the Xbox store, link my account, download Gears of War 4 on my PC.
That's how
but
I play.
But because they're trying to push the Xbox One X, all the games that they were showing off are
Xbox
being released
One F exclusive
during
that
time. Yeah,
cool. The PC master races, please, again.
but when I talk to the devs there will be PC features. Like, most of the time they are console ports, but you can push that little bit of extra.
Like, just raise that frame rate cap, and then that's the one minor step you need to make that'll make us all happy, and then give us other extras.
I mean, when you played it, I felt like I was playing 60 frames per second when I played it.
Oh, man.
It was smooth.
I was just more just there. I was doing too much on the screen to even worry about frames. There was just cars being... Did I mention a black hole gun? Because that... I was clearing... Just the, because you know how you would clear sectors?
Yeah, yeah.
In record time, because I was just shooting out black holes and everything was getting sucked in. Yeah.
So did you guys hear, is it true that you can destroy everything in the game?
Right. So I don't know if you know about this. This is interesting.
If you're multiplayer. Right?
Apparently the game has 100% destructible environment, but only in multiplayer.
Oh, that's...
This might be the first instance I've ever heard of a multiplayer, like a game that's got a single player campaign and multiplayer, but the multiplayer is actually more powerful because it's Microsoft pushing their new Azure cloud-based technology.
Interesting.
So they're taking a lot of the processing power and putting it in the cloud. So when you're playing multiplayer, you're actually getting more detailed environments that are 100% destructible because all the information is stored in the cloud. So my concern is what that's going to do to people's ping rates and the data that's coming through.
Oh, man,
like, I don't even know. I don't know how they're doing it. I'm anxious to see it working because so far it's just been said.
Well, let's see.
I mean, I could be wrong. If you guys know in the comments that Is there a game out that's already using this that we're just unaware of?
Yeah,
let
I've
us know. I'd like to, I'd like to know more about it.
Exciting.
I just know that they've been talking about this, that they're that's what I thought was interesting too, and I'm wondering if the technology is where it is, because when they first announced this, that was one of the big selling points. This year at E3, I didn't hear about that at all.
Yeah.
They weren't talking about the multiplayer of Crackdown.
Yeah, here's what I think is happening. They're testing the Azure framework before they roll it out to corporations. So you put it in a heavy load situation like a video game, mm-hmm. and because you know an office isn't going to have that.
It's basically we're watching the show Silicon Valley is this. It's data rate compression and discovering they should be doing this for video games instead of file compression for offices. Test it with a video game first. Why not?
Yeah, exactly. The perfect load testing scenario.
Well, for sure. You guys, I'm excited for this game. I'm going to play the shit out of it. I love feeling like a superhero.
Well, now that I know that you can destroy everything, we got to team up.
We got to destroy everything. Multiplayer.
Yeah. I'm hyped.
All right, we're all
certified
hyped. Let us know what you guys think in the comments below. Like I said, if you got to see this on screens at E3, it is pretty, so sharp. The colors popped like you wouldn't believe. It's really a shame that now we're having to find out about all these games on computers. It just doesn't do it justice anymore, and we're always going to have these reactions to them based on how we see a YouTube video where the bit rate is so low.
Well, that's why you got those 4K settings.
Maybe there's even that be a comeback to retail spaces. People are gonna like, before I invest,
you
want to
see
4K
it, you
want to
go
stuff.
See it in retail, maybe. Yeah. I don't know, because watching a 4K video on YouTube is still only probably like 3,000 kilobytes per second. Maybe it's more than that. Actually, YouTube's probably pushing like 10,000 kilobytes per second at the highest, maybe.
Maybe you got that Google Fiber, get that extreme.
But it's going to be faster than that when you're playing a game for real in your hands. That's a much faster frame rate a harder, data rate that you're getting to watch there. But anyway, let us know in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Bye.